I know that all of us are longing for community. We want to be with people. We want to see people, to share our lives with each other, to laugh, at the same time, even to worship together. I know I definitely desire this. However, after consulting with our board of trustees and our executive church leadership, we still think it's prudent to delay in-person live worship until the fall. Originally, we were hoping for an August 23rd possibility, but with the current state of cases and the environment that we find ourselves in at this particular moment, we think it's more prudent to delay, at least for a number of weeks. What we want to do is create an environment that has two things. One, that when we gather for live in-person worship, that it's a meaningful experience, and at the same time, something that promotes safety for all persons. So at this current time, we think that's difficult to do, and so we're delaying live in-person worship until the fall time, looking at the October period. Now, saying that, I do want you to know that we acknowledge that we crave a longing to be with each other. So beginning after Labor Day, there are events that will be on our campus, smaller in nature than a live worship service, but we'll have the possibility of live gatherings, different Bible studies that might start online and then move into maybe a hybrid model where you have people online and you also have people that are live and present in worship. I hope that you'll look for those on your calendar. At the same time, in the fall, we know that the weather changes for us, which makes it where we have access to maybe some outdoor events. So be on the lookout for different in-person events coming up in the next couple of months. We do hope that you can be a part of those. But just to recap, we're looking at October time period for live in-person worship. Thank you for your patience. Patience in everything that St. Paul is about and where she seeks to have her fingers in the community. At the same time, for your faithfulness, our church has been incredibly faithful to the ways that we can during this time of a pandemic. And I want to thank you for that. Thank you for your prayers. I hope that you'll continue to pray for our staff here. At the same time, that you'll pray for our church leaders as we seek to discern how and when and what's best for us so that we all can grow in our faith together.